It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. A beautiful day for a shootout. Which will it be? Which SDC? It's a beautiful day in my studio. A beautiful day for a video. Won't you subscribe? Like and subscribe. I have always wanted to have a viewer just like you. I've always wanted to make a video for you. So, let's make the most of this beautiful day. Since we're together, we might as well stay. Won't you be mine? Could you be mine? A subscriber. You know, as hard as it is to put on shoes with your legs crossed, I just want to talk about small diaphragm condensers today. You know, they really are fantastic microphones for drum overheads and even vocals. I'm too fat for this. What we're gonna do today is a small diaphragm condenser microphone shootout. Everything from the KM84 to the Octava MK12. So stick around, kids. You're gonna love this one.
Welcome to JML's YouTube channel. You're here at Kismet Studios in Brooklyn, New York with Joshua Rua and Joshua Lutz.
Today we're here to do a small diaphragm condenser shootout, and yo, do we have a ton of incredible small diaphragm condensers. So, what kind of SDCs are we using today?
Today we're using FET-based small diaphragm condenser microphones from a variety of companies, from the legendary Neumann KM84 all the way down to a Shure SM81. We've got AKG C451EB to compare. We've got, we've got something quite special actually from the Kismet vault.
It looks kind of ridiculous. We've placed all the diaphragms coincidentally in the same line of space and time. We had to squeeze them in, so they're in about a space about this big. We're gonna sit back on the mics a little bit instead of being right up on them.
And one of them is not a condenser microphone.
Dun dun dun!
One of the mics is a very special microphone from the Kismet vault, which is a Neumann KMS85 that's been modified with a KK84 capsule. The KMS, interesting fact, was released only 1 year, in 1971. The S stands for soloist, so this microphone was actually intended by Neumann to be used as a live handheld microphone for a vocalist. And it's got a really cool design, but basically, aside from the head basket, the body and the capsule are near identical to a KM84.
84.
Yeah. The KMS85 was originally an Omni capsule, which would make sense because, you know, the singer is looking like this and like this. The one that we're going to be using has been modified with a KK84 capsule, which is cardioid.
Yeah. Very cool, very cool. And very we have cool. A KM84 in the mix. So that'll be interesting to see how it sounds.
It will be interesting.
You know what's really cool about that is we're gonna see what kind of influence that new basket has on that capsule.
That's right,
because
that's
the same capsule.
It's the same capsule.
I've always thought that that S microphone is very similar to the PM750 by Gefell, which is their handheld version of the, you probably know, I forgot. What capsule is in the PM750?
Probably the M70 capsule, which is the similar, yes it is, M70. These capsules were meant for the Neumann Gefell M582, which is the tube small diaphragm condenser, or the M692, which is the transistor version of the same idea. And these microphones had interchangeable capsules, either screw-on capsules or set-screw capsules.
That's right.
And they've got the M70, which is cardioid, the M94, which I believe is also cardioid, and the M58, which is Omni.
I just have to say, Joshua's mic collection is no joke. And I pride myself on my mic locker, but I unfortunately still cannot hold a candle to yours.
Well, I'm an obsessive. I just got, once I start learning about something, I want to know everything there is.
Some people have a mic locker, you have mic lockers.
I need to move, actually, because there's too many mics here.
It's absurd.
It's a blessing. It's a good problem.
But YouTube gets to benefit from it today because we have a wonderful collection of SDCs. So let's jump right into it right now. We are going to be recording through the wonderful Electrodyne console, once owned by Patti Smith, from the Helios, Sphere, and Quad 8 family. If you haven't seen the Electrodyne in our past video, please take a look.
We're going to be recording through identical preamps on the console. No EQ to keep things fair and flat between all the microphones. There's going to be no other processing. The mics go directly into the console, and then they flow directly into the interface via the patch bay, and they're all normal. So, yeah, on the interface, if you're curious, it's an Antelope Orion Gen 3 32 Plus.
And to eliminate all other variables, we are going to be recording at the same time all the mics on one source. And today we're going to do an acoustic guitar. I have a beautiful vintage 1973 Martin D18. We're going to hold a snare drum about 5 feet back from the microphones to emulate an overhead scenario, and we're gonna record a vocal, quick little vocal, and maybe some percussion just to test this out. So let's do it.
Let's do it. So beautiful to me, you are so beautiful to me, you are so beautiful to me. You are so beautiful to me.
are so beautiful to me. You 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 are so beautiful to me.
Okay, so there you go. One of them, surprise, surprise, was a dynamic microphone. That's right, it's a small diaphragm dynamic. And it is a hypercardioid mic as well. I wanna hear in the comments below what you think about that. That was the Beyer Dynamic M201. So Joshua Rua, why don't you tell us a little bit about that mic, because it has an interesting history.
Yeah, something interesting about that mic is that there is another microphone which is basically identical to that mic called the Revox M3500. The only real difference being that the Revox has a different EQ curve. It's got a slight boost around 5K, not mistaken, which just brings a little air into the high mids and gives it a nice lift.
Hypercardioid?
I believe so, but that's why the Revox M3500 is a secret weapon on snare drum. Mm. That is a lot of guys' like favorite go-to snare drum microphone. I have one. It's the one that we use most often here at Kismet for snare top.
My 201, my M201 is a TG. It's brand new. Don't you have a vintage 201?
No, I have the Revox. Yeah. But so, it's interesting, a lot of these microphones, especially, you know, vintage, Beyer, AKG, AEG, Telefunken,
BEAG,
a lot of these microphones were actually produced a lot of times in the same place, and then just slapped a new, you know, slapped a different brand on
it. And when Telefunken moved out of the factory, in Hungary, for instance, they left the factory to BEAG and with some of the same tool and die machines, and they were actually making EAG, BEAG out of old Telefunken factories with leftover NOS parts.
Wow. Like, for example, here's a very classic
D19,
branded AEG. You know, same microphone, same body, same everything, different logo.
So leave in the comments below which SDC you liked. KM84 is usually the top dog, so what do you think about them apples? Please make sure to like and subscribe if you did like this video. This channel is exclusively and solely funded by myself, so if you would like to help me out, I do have a link below where you can do that. Make sure to click the little bell up top so you're notified when I make these videos and you'll know what is cracking, Captain. So thank you, Joshua Rua, for letting us into Kismet Recording Studios. Check him out at kismetmusic.com. I'm Joshua Lutz. This is Joshua Rua. Thank you and good night. God bless. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. A beautiful day for a shootout. Which will it be? Which SDC? It's a beautiful day in my studio. A beautiful day for a video. Won't you subscribe? Like and subscribe.